sanctified and filled with the Holy Ghost. You've been chosen by God. That's your right. You are holy and blameless in His sight. That's your right. You've been predestined for adoption by sonship. That's your right. In accordance with His pleasure and His will. That's your right to the praise and the glorious grace which He freely gives to all of you who He loves. That's your right. That's your right. That's your right. In Him you have redemption through His blood and the forgiveness of sin.
If you're not saved yet, you need to get saved.
Because all we're saying is this grandma hold the ticket that God has for him. Get hold of that ticket. Don't have to wait till the corner boy say, but get that ticket, man. Get it now. 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 And start to walk in all the rights and privileges that are on the back of the ticket that you have because you're a ticket holder. Lord have mercy. Everlasting life is yours forever. You don't even have to fret about it anymore. The ticket is available to you. Doors of the church are open. Doors of the church are open. We're going to make two calls. One for those who need to get saved. And two for those who are looking for a church home. The first call is for you to grab that ticket. The second call is for you to learn about your rights and privileges as a ticket holder. The ticket of salvation. First call. Every head bowed, every time eye closed. If you want to accept Christ in your life, if you want to accept the ticket of salvation that's available to you right now, you want to accept that ticket. So I'm tired of praying. I don't care how long you've been in the church. I don't care if your family's been a member of the church a long time. I don't care if everyone already assumed that you've already done it. If you have not accepted Christ as your Savior, you can't work your way in. You can't get in because the family is saved. You can't get in because grandma been praying for you all this time. You have to accept the ticket for yourself. Or at some point recognize that the Holy Spirit has been living in you. And you accept the ticket that way. If you're going to accept the ticket now, every head bowed, every eye closed. Pray this prayer with me right now. Just pray to yourself. Lord, I need you in my life. I tried it my way. Now I want to try it your way. I want to receive salvation with all the rights and privileges thereof. I want to be able to walk in peace and joy. I want to have the opportunity to know you better. And I want to be assured of everlasting life. Lord, I accept you. I believe in my heart. And I confess now with my mouth that Jesus Christ is Lord. Because he died, was buried, and rose on the third day. And because I believe him and now confess him, the Bible says in Romans chapter 10, verse 8 and 9, that I'm saved. It's the grace of God that saved me. Not of myself. Not of my works. This is a gift from God. Every head bowed, every eye still closed. If you prayed that prayer for the first time with me, just lift your hand up and read along. Just lift your hand. If you prayed that prayer for the first time, just lift your hand. Nobody's sitting right now. I see you, brother. I see you. I see you. Anyone else? I see you. Anyone else? Just lift your hand. Don't be shy. Ain't nobody looking except me. Lift your hand.
Amen. Amen. Second call. Second call. Second call. Everybody in, put your hand down. Receive it. You've already accepted Jesus Christ as your Savior. You've already accepted the ticket of salvation. But today you learned a little bit about your rights and privileges. So you want to become a member of a new vision. So you can learn more about your rights and privileges as a ticket holder of salvation. If that's you today, every head bowed, every eye still closed. If that's you today, just lift your hand up and we go. That's you, sir. I got you, brother. I see you, man. Thank you, man. Is there another one wants to lift their hand? This is to become a member of New Vision. Say, I got to start walking in the ways of the Lord and understanding my rights and privileges. If that's you today, just lift your hand up. Lift your hand. Lift your hand. Amen. You may be seated in the presence of the Lord.
Let them know that because they
your Savior, because they're your child, that you're doing this because you want them to know that you're their God. Help them, Lord. Bless them, Lord. Bless our community. Bless our neighborhood. Stop the violence. Stop the violence. Stop the violence. Stop the violence, God. Stop the violence that's going on in our communities. Every boy, every young man, every person that lifts up a gun to somebody else, let their hand shake. Let the gun drop from their hand right now in the name of Jesus. Bless those who are stretching out on faith in tithing. Even if they only have $10, they're tithing one. If they have $20, they're tithing two. If they have $100, they're tithing 10. Whatever it is, bless them, though. And show them that you open the windows of heaven and pour out a blessing on them. We ask all these things in Jesus' name.
Anniversary work, please see Sister Marilyn
Okay, just quickly, because we are running long.